Right, I am going to work with Drystone Paul this morning. I'll link his Instagram below. So we're going to do some drystone cladding. He's been on with this for a few weeks. I went up a couple of weeks and helped him set the frames up. So there should be a video out by now on that. And basically, we're just going to cover some basic steps on what you need to do. I mean, this one's not perfect because whoever put the block work up behind it again is wonky. That seems to be a running trend with any of my cladding jobs. But yeah, simply, this is just going to be basically how to do simple cost cladding and what you need to be looking out for and what you need to be doing to get it done. So I'm just going to do that today with Paul. You've probably seen him in some of my other videos, like I say, but he is working locally to me, like literally 2 minutes up the road, so it just seemed convenient to jump on that job and show you. Right. Right then, this is it. Here with Drystone Paul, give us a wave.
Good morning.
There we are. So this is what he's got up so far. You can see the frames there that we did the other week. The video should be up by now if I've edited it properly. So what we are going to do is we're just going to work on a small section. We're going to run two or three lines and then we're just going to course through those three lines at the length of this and just show you how it goes. But as you can see here, you can sort of see here, there's a good example. There's a stone laid on, nothing behind it yet. So what we're going to aim to do here is put some mortar in here, mortar around the bottom, fill the joint with fill and then gear at the top like this. We only put the fill in mainly to save on cost, but it doesn't make any difference to the structural integrity of this wall because it will have a layer of mortar below and above that will push through and we compact it down so you can see what's there. So yeah, but you can see from here all the courses, and this is the stone that we're using. It's lovely, lovely stone that's all been cropped nicely for us. There's a pile there, there's some piles up there, and it is racked back at the minute because we just weren't sure what was happening with this wall. But if you were just wondering, that's why, because they haven't made quite a decision how this is going to be joined yet. So anyway, I'll set up the camera and then we'll have a little look at how we're doing this. So Paul is just going to stick his tape on there. If you look there, that's a 9 centimetre. So he's going to pick that up, and then what we're going to do here is we're simply just going to place it on the wall like that. So once he's happy, other way up, there you are, look at that, beautiful. So now what we're going to do is we're going to find another 9, and to set up your lines we're going to put a 9 right at the other end now. So we're going to put one just over there. Found another 9. Look at that. It's like butter, that stuff, isn't it, Paul?
Yeah.
Lovely. There we are. Another 9. So that is going to go just up here. Just like that. Maybe not. Maybe there. Right, there you are. Because why have you done that, Paul? Why did you move it? Just explain.
It's slightly lower on that side. Just sits a bit better.
Sits better. So there you are. So now what we're going to do is we're going to run a string line from here that touches that and does not sag in the middle, so it's nice and tight, and then touches that one up there, and that will be our first course. So we will get that one on and then we'll move on from there. So that line is now on. What we're going to do for the purpose of filming is we are just going to fill this this row in here. So I'll just do a little time lapse, and then when we finish that we'll go on to the one above and I'll show you how we are backfilling it. Right then, you can see that little course is on there. I'm going to try and not neck myself on this very, very well put together piece of sort of lift. So as you can see there, can you see little pins under hot stones? So this is all in line now. And obviously if this was just dry, that would be weak. But what we're going to do now, you can see them little cross hatches there. They've been put in so we can get a bond to our mortar. So what we're going to do is get the cement now, put it in here, make sure every little piece has got some mortar in it, and then what we're going to do is put the fill in and then another top layer. So I'm just going to film one or two pieces of stone getting done and then I'll show you as soon as we've finished. So we've got Mr. Paul.
Hello.
Right, and now what he's going to do, Will, is I'm going to put this mortar in here, seeing as I'm doing it one-handed. So, you see how we're chopping it in between the joints there? And then I'm going to make sure it's all pushed in as much as I can. You're almost filling all gaps up at the back, like a little bed there. And you can see all that is catching on what we said earlier, these crosses here. And then at the next side of that stone, same again. Nice, push it into all joints like that. And then what Paul's going to do now is he's just going to backfill this little section behind with a bit of fill for me. So he's going to put that in there like that. Can you see how that's all going to stick into that bed? So he's just going to put a little piece in here. If we can, if we've got something, anything. That'll do, won't it?
Yep,
that'll do. And then all we're going to do to top it off, same, bit of gear on top. There, like that. Finish it off, and then we'll just put our crosses in, you see, like we did before. So now we're going to do that for this whole little stint here, and then repeat the process. I'll show you once this bit's finished. See, Paul there's just flattened it off, and now what we're both going to do is just put some of these little cross hatches in like this. One, two, three, all the way along, nice and easy. Just so that the next course got something to bond to. I mean, to be honest, today, probably not much of an issue because we're going to be putting another course straight on top. But if you were to leave this overnight, you wouldn't want a nice smooth surface for you to try and bond back to the next day. You'd want something like that. And this is the same if when you finish a wall, you're putting flags on top. Again, you want this in so that the flags, the mortar that you put the flags on, we have something to bond to. Right then. Now we're going to eight. So, what we're going to do here, put an eight on again. I've just stood in front of the camera. So I'm going to put that like that. And then again, where Paul is just setting up that little bit down there, we're going to put another eight on there and set a line on just the same. I'll do that now and then I'll quickly run along and show you how that looks. That's how we've got this line tied on. And if you see there, that's this next course. And then we've got that on at that end as well. So now what we're going to do, same thing again. We're just going to cross this joint here, work that through, and then backfill it the same. So we'll show you that now. And then we're going to do another course on top and just take it up probably somewhere near them ties, because these ties are what actually bond this to the wall behind. But once we get somewhere near that, I'll show you that. So this time you can see his bed below is already wet. So all we're going to do with this is push his fill in this time, like that. And then once we've done that, we can then get a bit of mortar and go over the top just as we did before. If we leave a little bit of space like that, anything with these gaps again, we can still fill those. But yeah, it's just as you go up, it changes slightly because this is already nice and wet. So I'll just get some mortar now and show you that. Get some nice lumpy gear. Just go in between the edges again. So we're just going to fill this in like that. And then once we've got there, we will fill in the rest of it. We're just going to nicely pack these out. And then once we've got that packed, so this one probably won't bother with fill down the back because there's just not a lot of room because this stone reaches the back. So you're just going to make sure that's nicely packed like that. Again, and then we're going to get some fill as we did before, get that in there like that, a bit more like that, nice little bit in there, and then get some more of this gear, boom, whack it in. This is also a mix of sharp sand and building sand, which I like to use. Everyone can do it differently. I just have really good results with this, and that's what I've chosen to use over the years. It's usually around 4 building sands to 2 sharp. You can do it 50-50. So that's that done again. And then what we'll do is do the rest, and then we're going to go up again another course until we get to this, and then I'll show you how to use these ties. Just pointing out these wall ties here, because we didn't put these in, because we would have measured them, you see, they're all at different heights. So what you can do is just bend them to where you need them to be. So if you see that comes under that stone there, what we're going to do when we put the next stone in is make sure there's some mortar around that, and then obviously mortar backfill that, which will make it really secure and stick this wall literally to the block at the back. So what we're going to do now is underpin these. This is the last course we're going to be doing today for this video. What you can see here as well is that line pin was in the wrong place. The wall pin. So what we've done is we've moved it into where there's a bit of a groove there. And then when we put the next stone on, we'll fill the bed there with mortar and fill that in. So all I'm doing is getting that in there, nice and compact, like we said before. Getting that here, chopping it in nicely like that. And then you'll see it'll all look nice and smooth by the time we finish this. So I'll just put the rest of it in now. So we've got some in there like that, that there, that there. All along here, and all this is digging into the mortar below to make sure we get a good bond. Where are we? There. In there. In there. And then I'm going to put my trowel down there. Get that in there. Oh. Like that. You can see then that's going to have a really nice bond to keep that line pin, wall tie in there like that. What I might do, because it keeps trying to pop out at the minute, is I'm going to get a nice piece of stone. Paul, would you just pass the piece of stone like that one they've been using? Yeah. So I'm going to get a nice piece of stone like this. I'm just going to rest that on there so that can be lifted off tomorrow once that's all set. And then obviously another stone will go straight on to replace that. Other than that, filling it, all your joints, make sure it's nicely filled in like that, nice and whacked in, and that's it really, simple as that. Don't overcomplicate it, it is really, really simple, and obviously you've got the added advantage of you've got the mortar in there, so like we said before, you don't have to go length in with these. Odd ones, pretty good, you know, to get it all the way through. As I was saying before, 10 out of 6, you can see, I'd be quite happy with this. You know, there'll be people that do it different ways, and I'm sure there'll be people that don't agree with me on some things, but everyone's got different methods in there. This is mine. So yeah, don't forget, because we're going to be leaving this for another day now. Put our nice little slots in. See how it's popped out again there. So that'll probably have to get tied in tomorrow. But we'll leave that, see how it is tomorrow. So there we go. Done, dusted. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe.